Bitches will stab you in your back, but smile in your face. Niggas will act how they act, but they want your place. Say that it's love out their mouth, but that should be fake.
Fake.
So I've been looking for peace and begging for space. Lord, I'm just a nigga trying to win. Woo. Lord, I'm just a nigga, so I sin. Ooh. We spin his block, we spin again. He gotta pay for what he did. I've been feeling pain for so long. I done became numb.
Sorry.
Right. Welcome back to the Too Familiar podcast. I am Marlena Ariel.
And I'm Tish B, your girl Sheena. You can call me what it is, but don't call me shh.
You can call me what it is, but don't call me what it ain't.
It's your girl, Miss Leo, baby.
Okay. You want to shut that?
Era. Call me now.
Yeah, shut the door.
And we have a special guest back. Yes, it's not too, have we had a guest on twice yet? Is Caitlin the first one?
Yeah, she is.
My first name.
Oh.
You already know who it is. It's Macintosh and Avita.
Do not call me by my girl.
For real.
Y'all, we got Miss Katie Cuss herself back in the motherfucking building.
Macintosh.
How you been?
She just said, don't call her. Nothing else but Macintosh.
Call me Katie, but like, not the fool, you know.
I can't help it.
Or Macintosh, nigga, don't tear everybody in.
Yeah. Okay, Macintosh. How many times have you heard me really say Macintosh? Only here and there.
Call me Macintosh.
I did, but not lately have not been calling her by her first name.
Yeah, you're right.
It's hard. She used to call you by your first name, so then it just picked up.
No, Macintosh.
No. I ain't gonna say that because you don't want me saying that, but she was used to like be talking. Look, I can't do it. And she like, you know, yeah. So I just.
Oh, yeah. But originally, like, when she first started calling Macintosh.
Yeah. Because that's what she introduced herself as.
I guess you didn't like Macintosh. I just assumed that you didn't like it because she was calling you by your first name. So I was like, okay.
No, I don't know how it switched. I don't know when I started.
Because my lifestyle switched.
And I stopped spelling your name the way you spell it. And I spell it Macintosh.
Nigga.
We don't know who that is.
Right.
That's her. That's me.
How has first of all, I was going to say, how's your week? You can tell us how your week been, but we also want to know how, like, we ain't seen you in a couple months on here. They need to catch up with you.
In the
meal, talk in the meal, right. In the ration.
Nah, man, it's been busy for real. My son started school. I started barber school. I didn't went on a little party.
Period.
Little boat.
You went on a boat for the first time, y'all. Caitlin is so damn scary.
Second time, third time actually.
Third.
Yeah. Now, like, this was like a party, so
yeah,
it was lit though.
Was your the other boats was that small, or was it?
No, see, this boat was bigger,
yeah,
than the other boats I've been on.
Period.
Yeah, it was scary at first, but after a little few drinks, you know, I'm back, you know, taking shots now, y'all. So
I take a shot.
Remember before, y'all, Caitlin was on her big, I ain't drinking now.
I've been drinking for a while now.
Are you a clear or a dark drinker?
Clear now.
Really?
Yeah. Now, when you start drinking clear.
Because it was heavy on that hand, dog.
Exactly.
Yeah. So now, I don't know. I can't drink like that. I still do not drink like that. Like, I'm okay. Like,
yeah.
It's good.
It's just, I can't be drinking that hand. That hand, something different. Now, that shit really got to be a real nigga. Like, for real. Like, I don't know.
I
can't do hand no more.
I'm real.
I'm a dark
tequila.
Person.
You is?
Yeah. I feel like I don't get no hangover.
Tequila. Mm-hmm.
Well, you used to like
Crown.
Crown. Yeah.
Crown,
yeah. You gotta grow up.
No, that's nasty.
Like, I was. The Crown Peach. I don't know. That was when it was just smooth.
That ain't you
to
no
me.
More?
No, I'm De Leon for sure.
Not De Leon.
De Leon.
So
now
that'll go down smooth for you, huh?
I feel like it go down Chicago. Smoother.
I'll keep my bad, y'all. That night we was in Chicago.
And Tashina was showing her ass.
Man.
Man.
For her birthday.
I was showing my ass.
Yeah. At, per Everybody usual. Always showing your damn ass.
Hey, we was spinning the bottle.
Now y'all lying. Y'all got out here and showed y'all ass.
I wish I could pull the video up. It's so
Please pull it up.
As far
no, because you know you lying. What happened?
It is a video. It was literally, after we had we left the club, and then we went back to the room.
And we just went.
That's when you was acting everything. Like that. Yeah. Yes. It's a whole video.
You don't remember that?
We had all the bottles, and we played spin the bottle. Whoever the bottle pointed at, that's who you had to take a shot of that.
Really?
Yes. You had to. You was like, I got Crown Royal.
Like, it was so drunk.
I was not drunk.
Yes, you
will. I remember the night. But that. But I don't remember that.
Yeah, she found that quick as hell. Put it up to the mic.
Okay.
Dropping the bottles. She was so drunk that
I was not drunk. I'm look, just look, another high. Her. Look, crab walking.
Man.
Okay, why you keep taking the phone up?
Oh, cuz you got I gotta have it right here.
Twice. Okay.
Yep. Yes, look at
now that's just naturally me. I have a natural high. That's when I was social.
Oh my God.
Y'all just
that makes me low-key so sad.
I just say that they don't know the difference of me being drunk or not because that's me naturally like in my state of being goofy and fun.
Well, yeah,
girl, when I seen you drunk, your ass was sick as hell. Huh? When I seen you drunk, you was throwing up.
Exactly. When I'm drunk, ain't no fun to Sheena. I'm sitting there numb.
That's crazy. Yeah. That low-key make me so sad. I miss Elisa real bad. Aww, we ain't talked in a long ass fucking time.
I miss you,
Elisa. Shit, I don't even fucking know at this point.
Check in with a nickel.
You ugly. I be telling people like that's still literally I still to this day say that's my best friend. Like yeah. I feel like you know we grew into going in these different paths or whatever, but. Love her to death, miss her. But you know what I'm saying? I know, you know, we're gonna come back real strong and our relationship I feel like our relationship gone.
Picture of them recently. They didn't got big.
I know.
Oh yeah, yeah.
I said, look at them.
She's such a
lover.
Money. Yeah,
money. Watch
her
pop out with baby number three.
Oh.
Look.
But anyways, Tashina, how was your week?
My week was fun, y'all. I'm gonna be getting ready for Halloween real soon.
You know? I know. Are you excited for me to come to dad?
Yeah. Stop lying to us. Kevin, get on here.
I do be sending everybody off, but I'm coming this time. I'm not playing.
We'll see.
I'm coming. For real.
But yeah, I'm excited. I've been trying to get my costume together or whatever. So y'all stay tuned and be looking out for our story. Cause yes.
What you
finna be? Why would I tell you?
You're not gonna say it.
No, not online. I don't want them to know. They see the day of. What you gonna be? Exactly.
Should I tell you?
Yeah.
Yeah, you can tell.
She's that real nigga.
No, I'm gonna be Nelly.
Oh, yeah. Okay, okay. Mm-hmm. I can't wait to see that one. We gonna exactly. post pictures. So y'all gotta look. Y'all
yeah, make sure y'all tune in for that. Yeah, my week been good too. I started some, like, a new little adventure thing that I got going on. I ain't gonna say it yet because I haven't posted about it yet, but you know I'm really excited about it and I can't wait for y'all to tune in. It's gonna be real fun, so yeah, be on the lookout for that. Yeah, so this week I thought that we could dedicate this episode to my sister. She passed away 3 years ago.
Rest in
peace, Millie. And this week on the 17th is her birthday, so I just kind of wanted us to have Kaylin back, especially because I feel like you was kind of the main person kind of seeing me a lot, witnessing me a lot, go through what I went through. Mm-hmm. And then also what y'all was going through, seeing me go through it and y'all own feelings about it. So for people who don't know, my sister did pass away, and I want to hear from y'all point of view, like that night that we all got the call. I just want to hear y'all point of view, like, what was the call like? How did y'all feel? What was y'all experiencing on y'all way driving to Nene's house and all of that?
Dude, turn and look at me. Let's go first. Oh my God. Well, I was definitely asleep. And we play all day. I'm not going to lie. We play a lot, too much. So when I was asleep, I guess you had called me a few times.
You was actually the first person I called to.
Really?
And I didn't want to text you. I feel like that's why I kept calling, because I did not want to text that.
Yeah, I don't know. I don't know if, what it was, but I ended up waking up and you did text me. Mm-hmm. I didn't have my phone, because you know my phone always on silent. And I got the text message. So I'm just like, yeah, they play too fucking much. That ain't nothing to fucking joke about. Like, they took it way too far. So I didn't believe you from the text message. And so then when I called you, and Marlena ain't the type to really cry. When she started talking, like she... You hear it in her voice, like she was shaking up. Yeah, yes. And she started crying, which I'm like, that's when I knew shit was real. Like, mm-hmm. Okay, like, what are you talking about? Mel dead. Like, this ain't even making no sense. Like, why the fuck would she be dead? Like, I just didn't understand it. It didn't make sense to me at the time. And it was just like a whole bunch of stuff going through my head. So when you told me that, and I said, well, you know, I'm on my way, after you told me where y'all was, I still hadn't really moved because I was still in shock. And I mean, it may sound weird, but I really believe in like spirits and stuff. So mm-hmm. In my head, I was shocked because I'm like, you know, at this time, I'm not ready for if Mel came to me, like, right, for anything or said anything, you know. And I was at home by myself. So the first thing, I really sat on the couch for a minute before I even moved or did anything. And I called my mom because I'm like, that's the only person I feel like I can talk to or say anything about the situation, because that's not for me to go run my mouth to nobody else, mm-hmm. whatever. But I'm like, talk to my mom, because I'm like, I don't know how to approach this situation. Like, I have never dealt with death, especially that close.
Yeah.
Besides, like, your mom. Like,
yeah.
Other than
but that. Like, our, yeah, like, our age. Us, yeah, yeah, our age.
Like, I have never dealt with that. So I'm just like, Marlena just called me. She's saying Mel did. Mama did the same thing I did. Like, Tashina, shut the fuck up. Y'all play too much. That ain't nothing to fucking play about.
Mm-hmm.
I'm like, Ma, I'm so serious. And then when I started crying, she knew I was for real. Mama started crying, too. And she was like, basically asking me questions like, where is she at? Where Marlena? How grandpa is? Do my mm-hmm. daddy know? And I'm like, I don't know. Like, really, I just got the call and I just called you because I don't know what to do. Mom was like, you need to be heading over there. I said, Ma, I understand that. But right now I'm in shock. Like, my body, I couldn't move my body. Like, I was just mm-hmm. sitting there. And she ended up having to yell at me because I literally stood there, because by that time I had made my way up to the bathroom because I had to get dressed. And I was just standing there. Mom was like, Tashina, get your ass dressed and get going. And I'm just like, you know, I don't know. I don't know what to say or do when I get there. Like, I don't.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, but eventually I got dressed and I came, and I just felt like the environment, it was just so weird. Like, just because I have never experienced death, so I didn't even know what to say. It was just awkward. I still was in disbelief being on scene. Like,
mm-hmm.
I don't know. It was a weird feeling.
Yeah. It was weird.
It was.
My stomach already hurts. Oh. Like, even just thinking about it.
Yeah. But
that night, she ended up calling me. She was FaceTiming me. And remember, I was cooking some chicken.
Mm-hmm.
I was frying some chicken, and I remember just answering the call. And just like you said, her voice was shaky. Like, she just said, Kaylin, she's like, Mel did. I'm what? Like, I couldn't believe the shit. Like, I don't know. Just, I always still hear your voice, like the way mm-hmm. you sounded that night. Like, it was crazy. I can't even get that voice out of my head, but I remember her just saying that, and I think I just started crying right then and there. But I remember calling my mama. My mama lived right by me, so she came like quick as hell, and I'm just crying. Like, I couldn't even calm myself down. My mama made me stay there to like, look, I'm over here shaking.
I'm over here shaking. I look at the table. Oh my gosh,
that shit was crazy. Like, I'll never forget that day. But I remember just crying, like, Mom, like, oh my goodness. And she was like, hey, Larry, you got to calm down before you get on this highway. Because, like, you can't drive like this. I'm like, okay. So I calmed down a little bit. But soon as my ass got back on that road, I just bust out crying again. So I had to call my cousin. Like, I talked to Destiny about everything. So I'm calling her. And she like, you need to pull over if you're going to keep crying. Da, da, da. But talk to her on the road. And I remember pulling up and then just seeing Marlena, like, I don't know. It was just different.
It was like a stiff feeling within the environment.
Literally, yeah. Like, everybody was just standing there. Like, Muggs couldn't believe everybody just standing up against the wall, like, looking like.
Literally.
I couldn't believe it.
It was quiet as hell out there.
Yeah, it's just, like, weird because, like, knowing, too. I just feel like it's different pulling up to the hospital. Somebody they already did. You pulling up her body.
It's still in there.
So that's why it really was just like, and it's still traumatizing to this day. Like what I told people, like, Muzz and know that we seen Mel in the body bag coming out. That shit was crazy. And so seeing that, having her go in there, like, and I remember I never said nothing to you too. Like, I did kind of hate that we all let you go in there and go see her body.
I understood what Marlena was telling us on that, because it's like Grandpa Melvin wouldn't go in there. And it's like at the time she felt like, you know, somebody has to go in there. And like,
I know in my head too, when I seen her going there, I kept saying like, go in there with her, but I couldn't. I couldn't do that. That shit was so fucking scary.
My leg is shaking under the table.
So I was like, that hurted me. That hurted me so bad. And it's just like, I was stiff there too, like just seeing her like that. I'm like, this is the second fucking time I gotta see my best friend go through this shit. That shit hurt. I couldn't wrap that shit through my head, but
me neither.
It was weird. It was weird.
That's like, crazy that you say that, because that's how I was like when I was told you, like, I was stiff, like, well, I was stuck at home. That's what was going through my mind as well. Like, damn, she lost her mom, and then turn around, now we losing her sister. Like, that's a lot on one person. And basically, to have to kind of deal with everything on your own, like, you really have to plan the funerals. You gotta do this, that, like, that shit is overwhelming.
And like, back to back with, you know, what you being so young, I used to just be like, "What the fuck?
Yeah,
why?"
I was crazy. When we think back at the night, it's crazy. Everybody that pulled up, we like, this is so crazy. Like, this random. We always frying chicken. Frying chicken, literally.
Mine's in a crock pot.
See, I had already ate and was asleep.
I'm over here. I'm real life at home. Just me and my dad had just got to the house, and I'm literally about to start cooking. And I remember I'm texting my friend because he was finna pull up. And, like, she was cool. I literally had just texted him. Like, we was talking. And then Netta had called me, and she was like, "Lena, y'all need to come over here because the ambulance is here and Mel not responsive." And literally, I hang up the phone with her, and I'm like, "Dad, we have to go right now." He putting his clothes on. That's when I start calling Tashina. I didn't call nobody else first, and I was trying to wait on her to answer, but I didn't want to say nothing to nobody else until I had talked to Tashina. But then when she wasn't answering, I ended up texting her, because I just felt like I needed to say something to her first. And so we get there, literally I walk in the house, and like Nene, Netta, somebody else, I forgot her name, they was there sitting on the couch. You could see tears in people's eyes, but nobody was like crying at the moment. And then so I'm like, what's going on? What happened? Where Mel at? Literally everybody busts out crying. Nobody said nothing to me. And I couldn't even say, all I was like, I'm like, no. Like,
so
can
you
I
feel
just
like
stop
at
crying?
That moment you knew kind of already in your head?
Yeah. I feel like driving there, like, I feel like driving there, I feel like I knew, because it's just weird for someone to say she unresponsive. Like, that's just, so then when they said that, it just felt like immediately my body just got super hot for some reason. Like, I felt like, I don't know, I felt physically like I just got super hot, and I walked out of the house, and my dad was standing there. He didn't even walk all the way to the house. I literally came out the house, and I said, "Dad, she gone." And my dad literally passed out on the ground. And it just, I don't know, that night was just so, like, weird. And then having to call people and tell them what happened and all that stuff. And but out of all of that, I felt like it was probably like a day or two later, I got on Facebook finally. To like people was writing me and to finally respond and stuff like that. And I went to one of my messages from like these people that we grew up with, and they wrote me like telling me like sorry to hear about it or whatever, but they had wrote me that night. And so I had ended up asking them like, oh, how did y'all even know? And they had told me one of my cousins had put it on Facebook. And I felt kind of a little hurt by that, because that person had never called me that night. That person never called me still to this day. So it just felt like y'all didn't even know if I knew. But the moment mm-hmm. you found out, you put it on mm-hmm. Facebook.
Yeah, exactly.
And didn't say nothing to me. Like, I don't know. I just find shit like that weird. That, like, I don't know. I was, even though that's not,
I
mean, like,
I would have also been upset, because if you would never text me and I would have woke up and got on Facebook, yes. and I definitely would have felt some type of way, like, damn, like, why is this already on Facebook and why I don't know?
Exactly. Like, and for somebody to inbox me, like, oh, I'm so sorry. And it's like, I didn't tell you. Like, mm-hmm. how do y'all even know? Like, yeah, that was weird to me.
Yeah, that spread it fast, because those same people had inboxed me and was like, what's going on? Like, mm-hmm. You know, we hearing this. Is it true? And I'm like, you know, I don't want to be the one to say nothing, because that's not my business.
I feel like people should do shit like that. Like, let the family announce stuff like that.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Like,
mm-mm. That's weird. That was.
Yeah. So that was my night. That was a crazy night. I feel like that was the first time I ever felt like something happened, mm-hmm. and I felt like physical pain from, like, I don't know, like when my mom died. That was like, I feel like that was like my first heartbreak. Mm-hmm. But when Mel died, it felt like I died that yeah. night.
Oh my God.
It's okay.
That's why we got tissue. Lord.
I really felt like I died that night. Still to this day, honestly, I don't feel like I've been the same since then.
Yeah.
And I think, I think grief changed me, like, in the worst ways. Mm-hmm. And as much as I say, like, I'm healing from it, or I'm trying to heal from it, I don't think that I truly am, for real. And I don't think I know how to. I don't think I know how to ask for help. I don't think I know how to explain to people, like, I have other siblings, but it feel like literally my whole life, it was just me and Mel. And to lose that, and also plan funeral, deal with people, friends, meeting people that she knew, that mm-hmm. situations and all that stuff, like, all that was, like, very fucking overwhelming. I'm not gonna lie. And then having my dad, like, obviously he's sick himself, so he genuinely is not helping me with stuff. It was just, like, that whole time period was just a lot. Like, I really just was like, I don't know how I'm gonna get out of this. I don't know how to deal with this. Like, it's a very lonely feeling. And even when you got people around, it's a very lonely feeling to, like, think, like, you would never talk to your sibling again. You would never talk to your mom again. Like, I don't know. That's just a very lonely feeling to have, like, really in your spirit. I don't know.
I feel like it was definitely a difference, and I can tell that it was like it hit way different when Mel passed, because mm-hmm. I was around you when your mom passed, and I was around you when Mel passed. The way you handle, like, even just dealing with different stuff, it was different, because when Mel passed, I will catch you just like blinking out and just staring mm-hmm. into space. And that's why I felt like I didn't want to be overwhelming, but that's why I always was like there and around, like, always, Marlene, what you doing. I understand that you had to cry at the same time, but at the same time, I never wanted you to feel alone. And I already know, because that, like you said, that was one of your siblings that you were close to, like, you not really close to the other siblings. Mm-hmm. So I just felt like, knowing that you lost your mom and then lost your sister, I didn't want nothing. Honestly, I'm gonna just say, I didn't want you to think of, like, suicide, nothing. I was mm-hmm. that's why I kind of overcrowded you,
yeah,
like, always trying to be there and making sure you are okay. Like, what can I do to help, or how you feel? If you need somebody to talk to, I'm here. Or trying to just even make you laugh, even during that time, just like, how can I make stuff different? Because I needed you here,
mm-hmm. exactly, man. That's crazy.
No, yeah. Seriously.
I feel like that, because remember that episode I was crying?
Mm-hmm.
Because I thought about that too. Like, I can tell, like, I had lost my best friend when Mel died.
Mm-hmm.
And I used to always think about that. I'm like, I even had a conversation with one of my cousins. I said, I'm scared.
For real, no, seriously.
I said, I'm scared. Nope. I'm not gonna cry over here.
Stop crying.
Nope. Oh my God. But I was scared. Like, I just kept thinking, like, I'm gonna get a call one day. Like,
yeah, exactly. I wasn't ready for
not
that.
Not me shaking. Gary, you better.
I swear that was my biggest fear. I'm not
like
gonna lie.
I was gonna get a call and like they were saying, like, you gone. Remember, that's why I was crying that time we was talking in the car.
Mm-hmm.
Cause I already knew. I felt it. I lost you. Like, you ain't been the same ever since.
Yeah.
At all. And so it was just scary just seeing you go through that. Like, I always just keep praying. To this day, I still pray. Like, how can I be there for you to help you get through that?
Mm-hmm.
You know, cause
I feel like I had to be strong for you. Even at the funeral when everything happened, I feel like I hadn't really seriously cried until when I got up there and talked. It's like that's when everything like really hit me. Like, and I was even then I was still trying to be strong because I'm like, I don't need to cry in front of her.
Literally, that shit don't feel real sometimes.
It really like, don't feel like I don't know. The shit feels so fucking weird, and I think. I still feel it now, but I think at the time, especially, I felt like I was really trying to, like, even to Sheena know conversations that I had with my sister, like, I was really, like, I started getting my shit together to open a group home. Like, I was trying to do anything to get, like, people who knew Mel knew, like, I just felt like I needed to have enough to take care of her. And then it was like...
Literally, you always said that too, like, Every time Mel called you, you was there.
We was trying to get this podcast going.
Man, like, a lot. Exactly. Die, like, man. All this shit really, when I really think, and I truly think that's why I felt like I died that night. I felt like I didn't have an identity anymore because after my mom passed, I felt like it was important for me to get my shit together to take care of my sister. And I don't know. I think me questioning God a lot was more out of anger of like I'm like I feel like I'm trying and I'm working trying to do something. It always felt like why me? When and I know I shouldn't feel that way, but that's just how it felt like. It just felt like I don't understand what you're trying to tell me. I don't understand why I'm supposed to go through this alone. I don't understand why, you know what I'm saying? Like that shit just I was sad, but a lot of it was a lot of anger at the time. Now I feel a lot of sadness, but then I feel like I was angry as hell. I was angry all the time. But let me stop crying.
Can I say this though, based off that, I feel like during that time, you never really showed your anger. It was more sadness, like on the outside looking in. What can I say off that? I don't want to say you handled it well, because I wouldn't say like you handled it well, but I feel like people really didn't know what you were going through. I feel like it's times that, you know, around that time family events was going on, you would still like come out and show your face and try to smile.
But put on a mask.
Yeah, and I feel like that kind of ate you, like, and put more emotions on top of you because you never really sat and dealt with it and sat in your emotions.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I feel like I definitely... fake it very well, because I feel like I don't know what to say. And honestly, this is so weird that this is going on fucking YouTube, because I hate crying YouTube. In front of people.
And you,
I think that's my biggest thing. I really hate crying in front of people.
I feel like after Mel passed, I mean, me and you was already kicking it, but I feel like that brought us even more closer, because before. It was like, you know, at first it was like me and Mel. Me and Mel was always close.
Mm-hmm.
And I used to always say, like, Mel was my diary. She was never judgmental. That's who I went to about everything. Like, if anybody knew anything about me back then, it was Mel. Like, Mel knew everything. But after Mel passed, it's just like, it was like, I had to be there. Like, it wasn't no ifs, ands, or buts. Like, I know you my auntie, but I'm like, shit, this my sister now. Fuck that. Mm-hmm. Like, if anything, we got each other.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Yeah, I mean, I thought that
too.
You funny.
Like this.
Oh, she just got up. She said, "Wait, is we finna fight?"
I'm dead. Nah, I think I forgot what I was finna say.
Can't wait. Can I cry no more? Dude over here getting offensive, ready to fight me.
I didn't know what you just did. But what was I finna say? I don't know.
What do y'all feel like is y'all favorite memory of from like Mel or something that y'all remember?
Mel was so
I got so many. Favorite though? I don't have a favorite.
Yeah.
But the one I always think of off top, because Mel is just so hilarious, is when we was at camp in my Snicker. I'm definitely a hide your snack type of girl. I might be, back then I was thin, but I used to love to eat. So we was at camp, and I had hit me a Snicker under my pillow, and Mel's bed was under mine, so he's on bunk beds. My Snicker fell on Mel, and she said,
"Thank you, Jesus." Thank you, Jesus. She was praying for a snack.
Why did she sleep one night when we was at camp, and she was like,
"I want somebody rib tip." Yeah.
Oh my god, she knew it was yours.
No, she didn't, but then I was looking. It's crazy because right after it fell on her, I'm like, "Where's my Snicker? Anybody see my Snicker?" And I was like, "Oh, I think this is yours."
That is funny,
bro. And she would bust the fucking splits out.
Mel could kill y'all in a nigga battle,
bust the fucking splits out.
Party in my eighth grade, and she was battling somebody.
Her Tashina Freaknik parties that we told y'all about.
Mel shut the party down. Everybody talked about that. They like, "Man, your auntie, she cold. I feel like because she was more on the heavy side, they thought that she couldn't do shit. And that's why I be telling people, don't judge a book by its cover. Because she showed out on the ass.
Okay.
That is funny.
I think, and then one, Mel, y'all know, well, I don't know, you didn't know Mel at the time, but Mel was big on Vine. Back when Vine was Vine. She loved fucking DC Young Fly. And y'all know I love DC Young Fly. Now, back then, I did not think that nigga was funny. She put me on. But I'm like, no. But then when he started the podcast, I'm like, Mel, this nigga is funny. Like, okay, yeah, I see what you was talking about.
That's funny.
Y'all, Mel is the reason why I met my,
Period. Come on, matchmaker. Mel,
she used to put us on, well, me, I feel like she used to put us on all the, like, different social media stuff that was going on. And another thing I guess I really liked about her, that's my Chris Brown sister. Like, we don't play when it came to Chris Brown. Y'all
and Issa and Jacquees. Like,
yes, Mel was in love with Jacquees. And I said he was going to make it. And y'all see, he up there now.
He did. But he did.
Gonna make it.
Mel used to hate me and Tashina used to always be writing plays and doing a. Mel used to be like, okay, like, girl, oh, fucking hey. Like,
tired of our shit.
Mel was always sweet.
She is
just so sweet.
Mel was sweet to
everyone. Then when I had bought your gift, your mom.
Oh, uh-huh.
She released, she was like, "Oh!" She just kept the whole, and she's like, "Kayla, that was so nice." Like, you are a good.
That's when we went to Chicago, right? Yeah.
She just kept expressing it, like, "Kayla, that was so nice of you." But Mel was always sweet. Yeah. Always gave me compliments. I'm like, look at Mel.
Same birthday as my son. She has the purest heart that I knew. Mm-hmm. For real.
For real.
Everything, even if she had to give you her last,
it was her laugh for me.
Bruh.
That laugh. She funny.
But she scared me, though, when she was in Rogers for that period of time.
Man,
like,
I swear.
I feel like, okay, Marla, I'm about to start crying
so
again.
Bad. Like, that was
what's
a
Rogers?
Deep time.
Okay. Oh, we're about to stop crying. Okay. She was there. I feel like, too, another reason I was super sad about her, because I feel like she really, I don't want to say lost her mind, because I don't want to seem like I'm diagnosed or anything like that, but it seemed like she really lost herself after my mom died. And, like, that whole period of time just scared the fuck out of me. Like, I feel like, I feel bad because I feel like at first I didn't really take it serious because I didn't understand. And so, like, when she went and all that stuff, I'm like, what? Like, what the fuck is going on? Like, I really just didn't understand. And then going visiting her, witnessing her, it was like, this shit, like, I am scared for her. Like, I don't even know how to explain it. Like, that time, too, like, I don't know. Mel put me on the motherfucking emotional roller coaster.
Man,
like,
I ain't gonna lie, because when we went to go visit her during that time, and then how she was speaking, like,
yeah,
she basically said one time we were sitting there, and she was like, "It's a lady next to you, and she's mm-hmm. touching your shoulder, but don't be alarmed because she's not there in like harm." I'm not gonna lie, I freaked out, but at the same time, because she said that, I don't know if she said it to me or you.
About the lady, mm-hmm. I think she was talking to you.
But I felt like when she was saying that, she was basically referring to. In my head, that's who I was thinking, but at the same time, it was scary. I never thought Mel was crazy or lost her mind or anything.
Yeah.
But I did feel like she lost herself. But when she was speaking of stuff like that, I never looked at her like, oh my God, you crazy or none of that shit. I really felt like she was saying and really experiencing that. Mm-hmm. But it was kind of like her grief path, like the way she was grieving over your mom.
Yeah. Yeah. Like that was like she had tapped into a whole new like portal that I just just like I don't know. Like that was just
everybody
like
everybody handled grief different.
Yeah.
So,
yeah. Like, and then for me, I feel like I was sad, but at the same time, like, okay, you know, Mel was like living out a backpack in her final days. And it was just kind of like I gotta figure out a way for us to be straight. And then it was like everything was just for us, really, that I was trying to do.
And you was like always trying to put everything on your back, like taking care of your dad. Like even now, like you still taking care of your dad. Like everything was just always about everybody else.
Yeah.
She never had time for herself. Like, and on top of that, dealing with her mama grief still, like since then, like even now, kind of she still have everything on her back. Like she never had time to just sit down and really go deep into her feelings of how she feeling and grieving. But you wear good. Girl. I can say that. You definitely wear it good, but
I'll be thinking I do, and then I go home sliding down the wall. But I wanted to ask y'all too, do y'all believe in angel numbers?
I do.
Yeah.
Do you feel like y'all know y'all numbers? Like what's y'all numbers?
I've been seeing a lot.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. I see a lot all the time.
I feel like I see 10/17 a lot, which is my sister's birthday, but it's also my godson's birthday, Caitlin's son's birthday. Mm-hmm. And okay, I'm sorry, y'all. Yeah. I'm over here. Got that. I wrote down because it just seemed like over, I want to say this past year, I literally always, when I see a time, I'm always catching 10/17. I'm always seeing 10/17 written down somewhere. So I'm like, maybe this is like a sign. So I had wrote down, it's two different things. So I was going to read both of them to y'all. Okay. So it's a powerful reminder that our spiritual journey is never over. No matter the hardships or trials we face, 10/17 encourages us to stay true to ourselves and trust in our decisions. By embracing 10/17's meaning, we can also look forward to a fresh start and good times ahead. And then the other one says, when you keep seeing 10/17, the angels want you to be courageous in the face of adversity. You need to be the strong party in any relationship. Otherwise, your business and personal arrangement will fall apart, sinking everyone in that relationship. Your efforts will finally pay handsome dividends. All your troubles will soon be over.
It's deep.
It is.
Sound like it. Maybe that's, yeah.
For real.
I feel like it's God really like you having Jay on Mel birthday. I feel like that was really God being like, okay, I'm gonna bring you somebody.
Right.
And that's crazy.
Yeah.
You a blessing. That is crazy though, for your own Mel birthday though.
It is. I should call her and I'm like telling her happy birthday. I'm like, and then Kayla gonna call me telling her that she done had Jay.
Yeah. That's my birthday screen right there.
That's how do y'all feel about, because I've lost, so early on, me and Amari, who is someone I went to school with, we wasn't really friends like that, but we was cool. But then my friend from high school, Chevelle, she passed away. Have y'all ever dealt with someone passing away, like, in our age group besides Mill, or was that?
No, I don't think so.
I'd say no, too. That was my first. Like in our age group, death that I had to
do. Yeah. Us going to our friend Chevelle's funeral, that was such a sad moment. But I don't know. It just didn't feel like, I don't know if it's because we wasn't like as close anymore, that it didn't feel as heavy. And then I also feel like us being our age, when we think about people who've passed away, I think I get sad too, because it's like Mel ain't never been on a plane. Mel wanted kids so bad. She'll never have been a mom. She'll never see me be a mom. She'll never see the fruits of our labors of this. Like, stuff like that. It just...
When they die so young, it's just, like, it's sad as hell. Like,
And as much as people like think of the good memories and stuff like that, I feel like my mind just always go to that. Like, damn, I would never live a life with,
like, that was it.
And I think that's why it's important to me now, like, trying to create, or not even create, build a relationship with my other sister, Tyler, because it's like, I don't want to force it, but I really feel like I want us to, like, get to know each other. And but I don't know, it'd be feeling weird. But I also think it's just me, because y'all know I'm real awkward. So maybe I'm just treating it weird. Maybe nobody else thinks it's fucking weird. I'm trying.
She told me she talks to her side. Your sister.
You got a sister or nothing?
Right.
Now I'm supposed to be going to visit. So hopefully I do that before the end of this year. I don't know. But do y'all feel like y'all have any advice for me or anybody else or people in y'all position who are being the friend or the sister of someone?
Let people help you.
Yeah.
And let us be a listening ear to you, because I feel like some people do like shut that communication out, because I know you want to be by yourself and that's understandable, but sometimes, you know, it's okay to be vulnerable and like to express yourself. But that's only if you really have that close trust and loving people around you. And if you need help, ask for it. Don't just
Never feel like you can't.
But how did y'all feel through the situation? Because even through all of that, you lost your auntie, you lost a friend. Like, what do y'all feel like y'all just put it all on? That's just her sister, or like, what was y'all path to like when y'all was by yourself? Like, you all, like, you lost your auntie, like.
You know, it was a lot going on. But at that time, I felt like, because I feel like it was like a double wham to you. I feel like my feelings didn't matter at that time.
And then I just thought about it, like,
it was more important than what I felt like I had to do at that time.
For real.
Like, I don't know. Like I told you, I just had feelings, like negative feelings or whatever over the situation. Like, I feel like you had negative feelings. That makes sense. I feel like it was a dark cloud over you. And I feel like I had to be there. I had to be there to embrace you. If anybody else wasn't near, I know I was going to be there.
I feel like
so I don't really feel like I got to grieve until later in life. Like, actually really sit down and understand what was going on. But at the time, my feelings didn't matter. And I didn't care that my feelings didn't matter at the time. It was like, I need to make sure she's straight.
That's the same how I feel. I feel that's why I always just pray about it. Like, just asking God, like, how can I be there for you? Because it was scary just to see you go through that again. It kind of just, like, scared me. Like, man, like, now I have to watch her go through this all over again. So it was just hard, like, to the point where sometimes I used to question, like, I don't even know what to do, what to say. Like, am I doing this right? Remember, I used to ask you, too, like, you know, show me how to be there. Like, because, you know, she'll open up, but she won't.
That's so cute.
So.
That is.
For real, but like, she opened up, but she won't, like, you know, she have her mask on, and that's how she grieves. Like, it don't be no harm to us either.
Hit us with, I'm okay.
Yeah,
I'm
it don't be no harm either. That's how she was. Exactly.
Yeah.
So it was just hard, like, just, I don't know. So I just always just trying to meet her the best I could.
Do you feel like we was overwhelming to you?
Yes.
Say yeah.
But everybody, though, I feel like just everything was, like, everybody asking me shit, like, every, like, you know, but not trying to say it in a bad way, but yes, I do. I feel like, I don't know, shit just be with all the attention. I hate when, like, a lot of attention's on me. I know that sounds weird, but I just, when something happened, I was definitely like to go to everybody's hitting me up. Everybody asked me what's going on. Where's this? Where's that? What time are you doing this? Are you going to, like, all that shit was just like a lot to fucking deal with. But I do appreciate everybody, like Sydney, Colin, Courtney, Jadadi, like you, all of us coming together and like spending that time together again during that time. Like, I feel like that lightened the load, like us, them planning to do stuff like that. That was real helpful for me. If I had any advice for someone who was going through grief, dealing with losing a parent, losing a sibling, I think definitely, and it's very hard, but try not to lose yourself in that. Because just because someone else died does not mean that you died. Does not mean that you have to just stay in that grieving state. And even though I feel like I'm still grieving, you don't have to remain in that all the time. Like, feel how you feel in that moment and cry if you need to, scream if you need to, but, you know, try your best to get up and see the light and try to think positive about it. Because I definitely felt it was a lot of times that I was like, I'm not gonna make it out of this. And I think that's a big reason too why I left and went to Seattle, because I'm like, mm-hmm. I don't know. This city, I'm like, this whole city just got something against me. Like, I don't know. But yeah. If y'all dealing with something, you know, y'all can DM us if y'all need some advice or need somebody to talk to.
Just know. I'm gonna be checking on you all the time. I don't play that. I'm for real. Marlene already know. I know I got on her nerves, but I did not care as long as I knew you was okay.
I'm grateful. I still got my best friend here.
Okay.
Great. I feel like I'm working on it. I'm getting better. I know a lot of people tell me to go to therapy, and I know this is a dumb reason, but I really have a hard time opening up to people that I feel like don't really care.
Yeah.
And I know I'm paying you to listen to me. Like, yeah. So
you make it seem so harsh. So I'm paying you to listen to me.
That's how I be feeling. So I be like,
wait, that's funny.
Yeah.
I
went to therapy before. That shit was a waste of time. But I feel like you got to find the right therapist. That's really what it is.
I be thinking about it, but I don't know. I don't know.
I used to want to be a therapist.
Yeah.
But then I feel like even like that type of situation, I feel like constantly hearing it over and over, I think I would lose myself, because it's like, woo, that's a heavy hat. And what they got going on,
yeah.
Yeah. Because I feel like I always wanted to help people, and I was also a good listening ear. So that's what really made me want to go into therapy. And it's just like my own situation when I needed a therapist. It was just like, okay, I feel like I would be good in this.
Yeah.
But yeah, I don't know.
I can't see myself being no therapist.
And then, I couldn't either, to be honest. And if you get a client that kill themselves, I don't feel like a failure. Like, damn, I didn't do enough for them not to.
That'd be hard.
Yeah.
That's got to be tough. No, but Caitlin would be a terrible fucking therapist.
I know what
she'd be like, what'd he say? And you went back, like, I don't even care what your thought was. That's like,
I'll be pissed for y'all.
Caitlin would be talking the whole time,
but Caitlin is not like that.
She not. I mean, Caitlin can be harsh though.
Y'all for relationship advice, and Caitlin's like, man,
Caitlin can be harsh though. Like,
I feel like she. Well, maybe to you, because you're her best friend. I feel like Caitlin say what she needs to say and mean what she say, but she also take time and think about what she's saying to you. It ain't just like, I know, and I'm just speaking for me.
Yeah.
Like I said, that's your best friend. She probably talked to you like, it's shit. Yeah. Like, when I done had my issues, you know, she's like, I'm just going to tell you like this. Like, you know, you need to leave that situation alone, or, you know, you might end up something.
For real.
No,
try to keep it a book.
Yeah.
And, you know, okay. Oh, was you finna say something? Okay. I don't want to start crying again, but okay. Something that really was like really special to me that Caitlin did. We was at her house, and I think I don't remember if we planned this or if we just did it when I was there. I really don't remember, but we got paper and we had turned on gospel music.
Oh yeah.
And we literally just wrote down like everything that was making us sad, everything that was stressing us out, like wrote down all that shit. And then in the middle of the night, we literally went to the lake and burnt the paper.
Yeah.
And I don't know. At the time, that was just like, I needed to release stuff that I just did not want to keep saying out loud.
Literally.
And I don't know.
And if it y'all, felt good that night too.
I'm definitely feeling that. Yeah. I'm for real.
Yeah. It felt good that night, literally.
It did.
I came where I'm like,
we did hug afterwards. I feel like I needed that. Like, it just felt like, and then I feel like if you try it, write down the truth. Like, write down really down what you thinking, truth, really everything. What you feeling. Yes, like I feel like that really helped, and to not have to hear nobody response. Like, just write it down.
Yes,
that was so helpful. I don't know that. I feel like that helped me a lot. But still to this day, I cannot look at pictures without crying. I don't watch no videos, anything that pop up in my memories that, like, if I tagged her in it, I hurry up and get off and be like,
really?
Yes, yes, no.
That's why I feel like I had somebody talk to me about that at the other job because she had lost her mom and stuff. And she just said, basically, I asked her, I said, so how do you feel with people around you? Like, how you want them to be there for you? Because mm-hmm. I told her, like, by my best friend, that's where I feel like I do tell Marlene because I want her to speak to me because sometimes, too, I feel like I shouldn't bring nothing up. Because mm-hmm. I be wanting you to talk to me about it. But at the same time, too, I don't be want to just, like, bring the subject up. Like, how do you feel about that? Like, do you care? Because, you know, I've been wanting to
understand what you're saying.
Like,
yeah,
you know what I'm saying?
Yeah, because like, you don't want to feel like you overstepping your boundary, or not even that. Just like, I don't want you to be like, damn, this bitch always asking.
Right.
No, I feel like that's fine. Y'all can bring it up to me. That's funny. Brittany, too, one day we was talking and she was about to say something about Mill and she like didn't say it. Mm-hmm. And then she was like, because of that, like, I don't want to, I don't want to make stuff about me. I'm like, but that's how I be feeling about y'all, because I'll be like, y'all went through something too. Like, mm-hmm. even though I get what y'all feel for me, but I feel like I feel that for y'all. Like, y'all lost something too.
Yeah.
And I'ma cry regardless. So like, if you want to talk about it, just know I'ma cry.
You
know, but
we didn't have a couple moments where we didn't cry. And like, New Year's, it was like right before we came in. And it was
Oh yes.
And,
was
like, and that's when I told her, I said, like, I don't like talking about Mel to you because I don't want to see you cry.
Yeah.
And I was like, that's why I say I feel like I cry in my own time.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. But that
there's plenty of times I had to pray about the team,
like,
for real.
We
like
it was scary. Like, honestly, I just feel like I was a little bit stressed out too. Mm-hmm. And even though, like, yes, you went through that, but I think everybody around us, we went through a depressing moment as well, because we watched our loved one, like, you go through that again. Yeah. That was hard, though.
Yeah.
Like, I used to be talking to my big sister about that. She was like, you have to sit there and watch her old sister and dead body too with it.
Yeah.
Yes.
Yeah.
Like, to the point where I feel like I kind of wanted to run away from that shit. Like, it make you want to, like, yes, we been there, but at the same time, I feel like, too, I was kind of pushing myself away from it. Like, it's hard to explain. It was scary. It was scary. But
yeah, and grief will sneak up on you too, for real.
Mm-hmm.
It's been 3 years and still I'll be like, fine, 1 minute, and then don't, especially like it'd be certain songs too, like something to play or something to come up, a movie or something, and literally just trigger me, and I'll be like, damn.
I swear,
ATL
is one of those for me, because I always think about the time we got in trouble at
Rochelle
house, and Mel was like putting her hands all in the TV and we got a whooping. That shit, y'all blamed us or whatever.
Yeah, and every time I listen to Kirk Franklin,
really,
Melody from it remind me of Melody. Mel, y'all, literally, yeah. I was just saying something the other day too. It remind me of y'all, like, it remind me of Mel. I'm like, damn, that's crazy. Y'all used to be singing that song.
I swear, yeah.
That's my girl.
My other funny moment. Okay, this is the last one, and we're gonna get out of here, y'all.
But we gonna get out of here.
Because Caitlin just brought this up fucking the other day about when me and Mel had sung it.
We all sang at church.
We sung twice. Mm-hmm. Then we sung His Eyes on a Sparrow at church. Literally, when we was done and everybody started standing up clapping, I bust out crying.
Man.
I'm one of them kids. You know, kids get all weird and nervous when people singing them happy birthday. I'm one of them people. Mm. Like, I hate when so much attention on me and everybody just like, like screaming, clapping all time. I literally bust and I ran to the back of the church. Man. I was so fun. And Mel came back and she like, what? My they cheering, they clapping.
Like, dude, you would have irritated me as my child. I would have pulled your fucking ear. Go sit down.
Okay.
Go sit down.
Now everybody like, oh my God.
Because I
already
did that.
Man. But that's because, I don't know, y'all know that I can sing real good, and I just be getting nervous when people hear me sing.
I swear, y'all swear I couldn't sing for shit. Y'all used to be like, nah. I remember we had planned to sing that one song.
You can't sing, Idol. Though.
I can't.
Y'all swear I can't.
No.
It was all three of us, and they were trying to basically teach me how to sing. And every time I sung my part, they like, nah. And Mel was like, I think you should do it like this. And I swear I was killing it. Trying to move my mouth like Fantasia and everything.
Okay. I absolutely fucking not. You can sing?
Yeah.
Let them hear you.
Y'all know I can sing. I'm not going to sing right now.
You can't sing.
I can sing. Marlena, so you're not gonna say I can sing? You know,
no,
I can sing.
I heard you
Wait, you know what?
Let them know.
Kaylin sings certain stuff good.
Yes.
And it'd be weird too. It'd be out the blue.
Yes.
Like, remember I you saying that one thing good and I kept saying, say, you like, I don't even remember. I'm like, what?
And I don't remember, but yeah, I can sing, y'all. I don't care what you say.
Period. Just mm-hmm. got to sing class.
She can sing better. Certain stuff good.
Yeah, exactly. Especially church songs.
Mm-hmm. I'm a rapper, but.
You know. So, especially.
I'll
but.
Be in a choir.
Maybe we, I think we might need to
put something together.
We need to put a disclaimer on this episode, but we might go triggering somebody. But
about what?
Just like, you know, certain people don't want to be, don't want to watch stuff about trauma and stuff like that. Mm. Like, I don't know. These new kids, we need to,
they better, this is life. This is real shit.
Yeah.
But this ain't supposed to be for kids. You know, we got a rape routine.
Mm-hmm. Okay. But, this is dedicated to my sister. Love you forever.
We love
you,
man.
A light in this world, and we miss you so much.
Yeah. We love you.
Love you, girl.
Thanks, y'all, for tuning in. Yes. And y'all, this was a real personal episode. I don't think we had no episode like this.
Yeah.
Yeah.
It's probably gonna be my favorite episode. I ain't gonna lie.
Yeah.
And look, she could talk about it.
I know, right?
Yeah. This deep for you, cause
I've never said that whole thing. That whole what happened that night out loud. Like,
really?
No. I feel like I would have, like, if somebody asked me, like, how did she die or something, like, people asked me that at the beginning, and I would just say, I don't know, or something. Or if somebody asked me,
the conversation.
Yeah. Like somebody say about that night or something, I'd just say, oh, my cousin called me. We went up. Like, I would never
go up to detail.
No. And it was weird, like, when I had called, well, I think I texted Elisa, and she had said Dwight seen it, but Dwight didn't say it to her. He was like, I think you need to check your phone. And so that's how she seen it. She ended up calling me. Like, and then I text Bianca and them. Like, it was just weird.
Dwight, 'cause I thought he didn't. I mean, that is kind of something.
Yeah. So it was just like the whole thing, just having to call people too. And then, like, I had called my auntie. I think one of them had already called her, because when I called her, she was crying. And then we both crying. She like, I got to get off the phone with you, because we just both on the phone crying. Sabrina called me. She was crying. Like, it was just a fucking lot. Like, that was just a lot.
Crazy.
But anybody dealing with something for real, like, really stay prayed up and really get your relationship with God together, because he'll really,
you never know.
He will really guide your steps if you allow him. Mm-hmm. And we love y'all for tuning in. We know this episode might have been a little heavy,
be there,
but
for y'all too.
Yeah, and be there for each other as much as you can, as much as you know how.
You never know what the next person did when going through. So spread love and be kind.
Yep, and ask God how you can be there for your certain loved ones too that's going through that.
Mm-hmm.
Cause that's important. Cause you may be not knowing how to show up for them, but shoot, ask God for that guidance.
Okay. Yes.
That's what he did for me.
So this has been another episode of the Two Familiar Podcast. Make sure y'all subscribe to our YouTube channel if you're not already. You following us on
Cuts
Facebook.
In the building.
You already know, Katie Cuts.
Yeah.
Y'all following us on Facebook, Instagram, TikTok,
yes,
all of that. Stay connected with us.
My YouTube.
We love y'all.
Soon.
And y'all know.
Katie Cuts said her YouTube comes soon. You tried to overtalk her.
No, I was gonna say, and Kaylin, tell them where they.
Oh, okay.
Oh,
can
Katie
find
Cuts.
You.
Yeah, y'all gonna put it in the description. But
period.
And my YouTube coming soon. Stay tuned.
You know.
Mm-hmm. Period.
And we love y'all. Thanks for tuning in, and we will be back next week.
Yes, sir.
Bye.